Yo guys, what is up? Nonefots back here again for another video. We are playing some Far Cry 5 yet again. And I'm just gonna continue here. My objective is to take down Jacob today. I don't really know how smoothly that's gonna go, but we'll see. Yeah, now I'll just fast travel over to Jacob's regions. See if there's any quests I can do. Oh yeah, there's this one. Dang it, don't cancel. It's Herc's grandpappy is going to, apparently he has nominated me to be his campaign manager.
Got a new job for you. Do you know what gerrymandering is? Of course you don't. You're a regular American, just like me. It's boring egghead stuff involving redrawn voting districts, blah, blah, blah. Anyways, the election's coming up, and them eggheads tell me I'm fucked in the polls because those goddamn Peggies ain't gonna be voting for me. Say what you will about lunatic cult movements, but the bottom line is they vote. Now, the eggheads say the only chance I got at winning would be to go back in time and gerrymander them district lines so the Peggies ain't counted. And that got me to thinking I could just as easily win if them Peggies just didn't show up to vote. Now, I'm not telling you how to go about such a thing, wink, wink, but a permanent solution to my temporary problem would work best if you catch my meaning.
Oh, trust me, I got you.
Because that's still illegal. It is still technically illegal, right? But if there were less Peggies around because they somehow tripped and fell on several dozens of bullets, it would probably help my chances. The district in question is up at the crossroads by the Grill Street Diner. You can take my idiot son with you. He's not good at much, but he can shoot okay. And you know, if this were ever to blow back on us, it would be good to have Patsy. I don't even think he'd get jail time on account of him being a little touched. Well, what you waiting for? Get moving.
Yes, sir.
Target acquired.
Oh, target acquired, my ass. Did you? Plane just crashed. Or not. Going down. Better just make sure. Yeah, he's going down. Yeah. America! Fuck yeah! Hello, helicopter. How you doing? Aw. The helicopters are so easy to take down. It's kind of... Why do my bullets have to run out so fast? If I got down a bit, it'd probably be a little easy. Oh, that would be bad. A helicopter, whatever shall I do? Howdy there, partner. That was the easiest mission I've ever done.
Well, you did it. Nice work. You and I are damn sure gonna make Montana great again. Tell you what, how about you take old Nancy? You go around cleaning up this county in that truck, and all them prospective voters will know who's got their backs. Oh, and please don't bring Hurt Jr. back. Ever.
Button. Hey look, it's a clutch mixer. Oh, I need to free two more people. Gonna try this. Don't know how it's gonna go, but
they'll have to have a good grip on the wheel on those wooden ramps. They've got it made. That ATV could flip on the landing.
Oh, god dang it. Ow. That hurt. Oh no, come on, make it. Come on, you got this, come on. There you go. Yes, sir, I do.
We have a moose on the tracks.
Oh, I think I've almost made it. Oh, man. I can't afford to wreck again. Ooh, that one looks kind of close. Oh my, are you actually serious? Luckily this one's not too far away.
An incredible leap by our driver.
that's the end. Hey, let's go. Sick music, bro. Up. What the heck? Am I dancing? No. That was unexpected. What the heck is this? Well, I'm back in Jacob's hold or whatever.
Oh, you must be hungry. Did you know it takes 10 days for civilization to collapse? Yeah. You take away a man's basic needs and he will revert to his primordial instincts in just 10 days. That's a difficult thing to understand unless you've lived it. Well, I was in Iraq during the first Gulf War. 82nd Airborne All-Americans. Hoorah! One night there was an ambush, and me and this guy named Miller got separated from the unit. No food, no radio. Nearest base, 200 clicks to the south, so we just started walking. Well, by the third day I knew we were lost. Day six, ran out of water. You know what that's like, don't you? Difficult to swallow. On the seventh day, Miller's legs started going all wonky. Did you know your brain starts to eat your muscles in order to survive? That's why you're so goddamn skinny. And by the eighth day, the wolves were closing in. And I looked at Miller and I could tell we were as good as dead. And I accepted that. And in that acceptance came clarity. You see, I wasn't just looking at Miller. I was looking at an opportunity. And it wasn't something I wanted. It was something that I had to do. It was my test. You see, Miller's sacrifice wasn't about me walking out of that desert. It was about bringing me here. The weak have their purpose. You'll understand that soon enough.
You're goddamn crazy, what I think. The fuck? This again? Get a headshot, it gives you more time.
Know your purpose. Well done.
was like.
Call the weak!
Bad.
Strong enough. You have to get out of here before it starts again. Follow me. He knows you're ready. To do it. Look. Trials. See? He's got it all planned out. One, two, three. One, two, three. One, two, three. One, two, three. Then he's got you. It becomes second nature routine. He gets in your head. You don't even realize it. You can't ever go back. You understand? You can't ever go back. Come on. It's almost time. I've studied the route for weeks. It's the only way out. You'll be safe if you don't. No, not yet. Not yet!
Hey guys, this is probably where I'm gonna end it. Hope you enjoyed this massive cutscene of an episode. But we didn't kill Jacob this episode, which is kind of unfortunate. But you know, we can do that later, I guess. So yeah, I hope you enjoyed this episode. See you guys later. Peace.